Okay, this is the last video for this collection of slides. The only thing we're going to do in this video is go over this particular problem up on the screen. It is a bit of a complicated problem. You have to connect a lot of different pieces. It relates to freezing point depression. So let me try and take you through this. We are interested in this molecule called icosine. And icosine is going to be dissolved in a different liquid called benzene. So basically, we have a container of benzene. It's a liquid. It's one of the components in gasoline. And we're adding a little bit of icosine to it. What we're going to want to do, I'll just focus on the question. The question is, what is the molar mass of icosine? If you remember, molar mass is written as grams of your stuff per mole. So they want to know how many grams per mole in icosine. It's going to take a little bit to get there. Here's the information. We take icosine. This is a bunch of noise. And they take 100 milligrams of icosine. And it's important to remember that 100 milligrams is the same thing as 0.1 grams. They take 0.1 grams of icosine. And they dissolve it in 1 gram of benzene. So they take a tiny little bit of this stuff, they dissolve it in 1 gram of liquid benzene. And when they do this, it says the freezing point of a solution that has icosine and benzene is 1.75 degrees Celsius, lower than the freezing point of pure benzene. So what they're telling you here is that this is the delta T sub F number. That's how much the freezing point goes down or how much it's depressed. They also tell you the KF number. And one of the things that they don't tell you, but we can figure it out from algebra, is the molality. So we don't know the M number. But we know this number and we know the K sub F number. So we can just use algebra to figure it out. So once we figure out this, once we figure out the molality of icosine dissolved in benzene, then we will know number of moles of icosine dissolved in kilograms of benzene. But the question isn't asking how many moles of icosine are dissolved or anything like that. The question is asking, what's the molar mass of icosine? And like I said, molar mass is grams per mole. And what we will have is we will know that we have 0.1 grams of icosine. We will also know from the molality equation, we will know how many moles of icosine that is. And so all we have to do is take 0.1 grams and divide it by the number of moles of icosine, and we'll get the molar mass. But that's a little complicated, and we'll get there. So here we go. There are many steps. Like I said, we know the freezing point depression number. It's negative 1.75 degrees Celsius, so that's there. We also know the freezing point depression constant because they tell it to you. That's K sub F, and that goes here. And there's a negative sign, so there should be a negative sign because there's negative sign there. If you notice, there's a little m here, so they say the freezing point depression constant is 4.90 degrees Celsius per m. This little m means molality. And if you notice, the units on molality are moles per kilogram. So really, what this 4.90 was saying is 4.90 degrees Celsius per moles per kilogram. But these units are in the denominator. And so what you do when you're dividing by something like that is you flip the units around. So the units will end up being 4.90 degrees Celsius times kilograms per mole. Because this kilogram is in the denominator of the denominator, which means it pops back up to the top. So that's what I wrote here. 4.90 degrees Celsius times kilograms per mole. The only number that we don't know is the molality. That's written there. I'm going to simplify it by just writing it as an m eventually. But we need to figure out this m number. The way that we do it is we have to get it away from the freezing point depression constant, which means we have to divide both sides by this ugliness here. And we're going to do that. Over here, I've divided the left side by the negative 4.9, and I've also divided the right side by the negative 4.9. On the right side, everything's going to reduce away to 1, and the units will cancel. On the left side, the degrees Celsius will cancel. Then we're going to do negative 1.75 divided by negative 4.9. Negative divided by negative will give us a positive. And if we do 1.75 divided by 4.9, we're going to end up with 0.357. The other thing that happens is the same thing again. We have kilograms in the denominator. We have moles in the denominator of the denominator, which means it pops back up to the top. So moles is there. So we have just solved for this M number. And the M number, the molality, is 0.357 moles of icosine dissolved in every 1 kilogram of benzene. What that means is, if I had a kilogram of benzene, and I dissolved 0.357 moles of icosine into it, then the freezing point of the benzene would go down by 1.75 degrees Celsius. That's what this equation is telling us. We obviously don't have 1 kilogram of benzene. That is the same thing as 1,000 grams of benzene. But if you look at the problem, we don't have 1,000 grams of benzene. We only have 1 gram of benzene. So let's talk about that. So another way of writing this, this is just the molality that we figured out on the previous slide. We have 0.357 moles of icosine for every 1 kilogram of benzene. But like I said, 1 kilogram of benzene is the same thing as 1,000 grams of benzene. But we don't have 1,000 grams of benzene. We only have 1 gram. What that means is, if I want to take 1 gram of benzene and make the temperature, the freezing point of benzene, go down by 1.75 degrees, I have to dissolve 1,000 times less moles of icosine to do it, because 1 gram of benzene is 1,000 times smaller than 1,000 grams of benzene. So I only need 1,000 times smaller the amount of 0.375. So what I'm doing here is I'm saying, look, if I had 1,000 grams of benzene, I would need 0.357 moles of icosine to lower the freezing point by 1.75 degrees. But I don't have 1,000 grams. I only have 1 gram. So how many moles of, how many moles of icosine do I need? And you can cross multiply and divide, or you can just kind of reason through it. 1 gram is 1,000 times smaller than 1,000 grams. So X better be 1,000 times smaller than 0.357 moles. So if you take 0.357 and divide by 1,000, you end up with 0.000357 moles of icosine is dissolved in 1 gram of benzene to give you that reduction, 1.75 degrees Celsius reduction in freezing point. But, so this is true. If we have So if we have 0.000357 moles of icosine dissolved in 1 gram of benzene, just like we do here, then according to this equation, the freezing point of the mixture is going to go down by 1.75 degrees Celsius. But 0.000357 moles of icosine must be equal to 100 milligrams of icosine, because the question said that you dissolved 100 milligrams of icosine in the benzene, and the freezing point went down by 1.75 degrees Celsius. So what that means is 0.000357 moles of icosine must be 0.1 grams of icosine. Because if you remember a couple of slides back, 100 milligrams is the same thing as 0.1 grams. And what are we trying to do? We're trying to figure out the molar mass of icosine, and molar mass of anything is grams, which we have now, per mole, which we also have now. So 0.1 grams of icosine is the same thing as 0.000357 moles of icosine, but we want to know how many grams of icosine in 1 mole. And so we can set it up like this, where we have two fractions equal to each other, and We're just trying to figure out y, which will tell us grams per mole, and we can cross multiply and divide. And if we do that, we end up with the molar mass of icosine, which is 280 grams per mole. And if you look up icosine on the internet, probably on Wikipedia, you will find that the molar mass is actually pretty close to 280 grams per mole. So we did it correctly. So what we did was we basically figured out that we had a certain number of grams of stuff that we dissolved. We figured out how much the liquid weighed that the icosine was dissolved into. We figured out how much the freezing point went down. We plugged all of that in, and we figured out concentration of icosine in moles per kilogram, but we got moles of icosine out of it. And because we got moles of icosine out of this little bit, we could figure out how many moles there were in 0.1 grams. And once we did that, all we have to do is figure out how many grams are in 1 mole. And that was this cross multiplication here. And if we do that, we end up with a molar mass of 280 grams per mole. And this is a common thing that people do. They can estimate what the molar mass of certain things are that they dissolve in liquids based on how much the freezing point goes down. So that's it for this problem. I know it was a little complicated. You may need to watch it again, but that is it. That's also it for the lectures for this collection of slides. Be sure it was pretty brutal. This is the problem set that's due. So the first problem deals with Raoult's law. You have a certain amount of water, a certain amount of table sugar, a certain amount of another sugar. It says those sugars are not volatile. They don't make a vapor. Wants to know what's the vapor pressure of the solution. And it gives you some information. But that's pretty similar to a problem that we went over. This one is similar to the problem that we just did. They're taking caffeine. They dissolve 150 milligrams of caffeine in 10 grams of camphor. Camphor is some other liquid. They tell you what the freezing point depression constant for camphor is. They tell you what the freezing point depression number is. And then they want to know what's the formula for caffeine. So that's pretty involved. Good luck with it. But that's it. That's it for this deck of slides. Bye-bye.